In the old days of chip design, everyone pretty much stayed in their own sphere. Foundries were over here, OSAT stayed over here, and system companies over here. But now, with the rise of 2.5D chips and their advanced packaging requirements, with IC design flows changing so rapidly, and a move toward more heterogeneous computing, those lines have, well, gotten to be quite a mess. We need a set of IC design tools that can keep up with system integration, chip design, PCB and package analysis and design. Phew. Can someone get me an eraser, please? Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. Do all of these circles have you a little cross-eyed? Yeah, me too. Fortunately, John Park from Cadence Design Systems is here, and we're going to talk about how we can get all of these circles to play nicely together in your next system design, and how Cadence Design Systems is looking to bridge the gaps from chips to packages to boards to systems. And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find more information about system design enablement from Cadence Design Systems. Hey, John, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so we're here to talk about the advances in packaging, and we're starting to have to think beyond Moore's Law, right?
Yeah, that's certainly what we're seeing from the advanced packaging side of the equation. We're seeing a couple big trends as people look for alternatives to scaling just based on Moore's Law. They're starting to look at designs that we call heterogeneous integrated designs, where they take multiple dies, or in some cases multiple chiplets, and integrate those together onto a single package or single carrier. There's lots of advantages to that, and I'm going to follow up in the next couple of slides to talk in more detail about how we see heterogeneous integration unfolding as we move forward. We also see another trend where we used to have a nice clean line between what was the back end of the IC and where advanced packaging technology came in. Now that line is starting to blur, and in some cases that line is completely gone between IC foundry and advanced packaging. And I'm going to give some examples of that and how that's directly impacting the technology that we're developing at Cadence Design Systems.
Okay, so let's talk about an evolving line. Now, we're not seeing that clear line between OSAT, foundry, and system companies these days, right? How did we get here?
Well, I think we got here because the IC foundries, the need to create more efficient packages, to create smaller devices that we need for today's consumer market, devices that need lower power. People have looked to these new advanced packaging technologies, and a lot of them are based on silicon substrates instead of the traditional PCB organic or laminate type substrates. And so we're seeing the IC foundries now become very active in what they used to call an IC backend, what they're now starting to call what it really is, which is advanced packaging. As the foundries start to do more packaging based on the technologies that we're moving towards, the OSATs, of course, also are stepping up their game, and they're also starting to offer some competitive packaging technology. So at Cadence, we've been working with both the foundries and the OSATs to develop reference flows and, of course, improving our tools so that they can support these new packaging technologies.
Of course. So you mentioned a new battleground in your title. Where is that battleground taking place?
So we see that based on foundries getting more involved in packaging, starting to potentially take some business away from the OSATs when it comes to some of these cutting-edge packaging technologies that the industry calls 2.5D, where multiple die are placed on a silicon interposer, and then that silicon interposer gets placed on a package. The process of creating that silicon interposer is typically a silicon-based material. It takes place in a foundry-type environment, although the OSATs are starting to offer some competitive technology there. And then certainly when we get to full 3D stacking of wafers, the traditional packaging step is completely gone there because you're staying at the chip level for that chip-to-chip integration. Eventually, that device will sit on a package, so packaging doesn't go away. But the new battleground is really the silicon-based and 3D stacking technologies that the foundries have started to develop, and the OSATs are trying to catch up in some respect for that. But I don't want to say that the traditional packaging is going to completely go away, but certainly on these advanced technologies, the foundry participates a lot more in the process.
Sure. So What's your place in this battleground? Do you guys have an attack plan?
Yeah, so we do. One of the things that's unique about Cadence is we do have technology in the chip domain, in the advanced package domain, and in the board domain. It gives us the opportunity when a new packaging technology comes out, it gives us the opportunity to look at what Cadence technology is best suited for that new advanced packaging technique. For example, packages 25 years ago were all mechanical-based lead frame types of packages.
Yeah.
That's market's still there, but that's not what we would call advanced packaging market. That kind of emerged in 89, 90 with the ball grid array coming out. With that device, that's when Cadence got involved with the advanced packaging market, and we developed our advanced packaging tools. And so as we move to these multi-tech substrates where you have a silicon interposer or you have an embedded silicon bridge, as we move to those types of substrates, it becomes a question of, is it best to do that in the packaging technology or is it best to do that in an IC process? And every customer has their own idea of what we should do. So in some cases, we improve multiple tools within our flow so that customers can pick the platform that they're most comfortable with to do the latest advanced packaging technology. And we go up to the modern day, what's happening now, and we see a lot of foundry-based fan-out wafer level packaging happening where it is a completely IC process. For the package that mounts directly onto the PCB. And we see, of course, TSMC announced their wafer-on-wafer technology at their symposium about a month ago. And so in that case, it is purely an IC process when it comes to the stacking of those devices. So at Cadence, we've started to improve our tools, add functionality to our tools in both the advanced packaging domains as well as in the IC layout domains.
So let's talk about this system integration, package, chip. How does this all fit together?
That's a great question. So from our CEO all the way down through the system, in fact, if you're at DAC this week, you'll notice the banners were all over the place using this term system design enablement. And so it's a Cadence-wide initiative to think beyond the chip and to think out into the full system level design, including package and board and system level analysis. So we have a big initiative at Cadence to think about the complete system level design. And that includes, you know, targeting specific vertically integrated technologies, the automotive market, the aerospace and defense market. And so developing vertically integrated cross-platform flows that tie the chip, the package, and the board together in a tightly integrated flow.
Okay, so tell me a little bit more about how the foundry works into this system.
We've had a long-standing partnership with TSMC, using one example of a foundry. It started back when TSMC announced their CoWoS technology, that's chip on wafer on substrate.
Okay.
What the rest of the industry calls 2.5 DIC.
Gotcha.
Is when we started initially working with TSMC and their reference flows for that technology, which at this point was about 8 years ago. And then we also got heavily involved with TSMC to develop reference flows for their InFO technology, which is the fan-out wafer level packaging technology that got a lot of attention last year. We were the first to market with a completely vertically integrated reference flow specifically for InFO.
Okay.
And then most recently, we announced last month our collaboration with TSMC to provide a reference flow for wafer on wafer, which is their 3D stacking. It's a combination of us working closely with TSMC's to not only improve our point tools, but more importantly, to improve the complete design flow for these types of advanced packages. And it doesn't stop, of course. You know, we are continually evolving in the packaging space, and TSMC is working on some more multi-die type packages, something they call InfoMS, which is a memory stack on a fan-out wafer level package, and something they call system on integrated chip, which is the ability to put multiple chips onto attach at a wafer level process. So we continue to work closely with TSMC to make sure our tools are approved and ready to be used by our customers when they decide to go after one of these advanced packaging technologies.
Okay, so I can imagine that OSATs need to come in here as well, right?
Sure, sure. The OSATs don't want to be left out. I think it's good. It's good for the whole business because now the OSATs are interested in developing reference flows and providing more content to their customers to make the design job of their advanced packages easier by providing almost the same level of reference flows and design kits that the IC foundries have. So we've worked with Amcor and ASC and other OSATs on developing reference flows. We announced our partnership with Amcor about a year ago on their Slim and Swift technologies.
Okay.
So their versions of fan-out wafer-level packaging. And then most recently, a really good partnership with ASE for something they call SIPID, which is System and Package Intelligent Design. So it's a full reference flow for anyone that's trying to design a multi-die package.
Cool. Okay. So what does the design flow look like here? Now, I know you guys have IC tools, advanced packaging, board design tools, but how does this all fit together?
It's starting to fit together much better because of the trends that we see going on. That's one of the areas that we've focused on, is creating these cross-platform, vertically integrated flows that tie our chip implementation and verification tools in with the rest of the flow, including advanced packaging, all the way to the board level, not only for implementation, but the ability to do electrical modeling as well. So Cadence historically, I think as most people know, has had very strong technology in the IC domain, very strong technology from our Allegro platform in the board domain, and we've had a very strong offering in the advanced packaging world, the SIP layout product and Allegro package designer. But where we've been doing a lot of investing is really creating the glue that ties all of these three different platforms together.
Okay.
So our customers that are starting to see these advanced packages that sometimes look like a chip and sometimes look like a package, they need to be able to move seamlessly between the chip domain and the packaging domain. We've announced a couple of vertically integrated flows to address that type of interaction. One example would be based on the info flow from TSMC, the ability to move from the IC domain, move into the advanced packaging domain for the RDL layers, and then take that data and move it back up into the IC domain for final verification and sign off.
Cool. Okay. So do you have any examples of this in action?
Yeah, we have announced several new flows. One is, as I mentioned just a minute ago, we're the first to market with our advanced fan-out wafer level packaging flow specifically developed for TSMC's info technology. That vertically integrated flow ties together the chip tools with our verification platform and extending all the way to our electrical modeling technology that we call Sigrity. So it's a very tightly integrated flow that allows you to start the design in one of our IC tools, move it pretty seamlessly into the packaging tools, where we also have the ability to do the electrical modeling. And then when it's time to do the sign-off, we can feed that information seamlessly back into our IC level verification tools. The other example is something we announced exactly a year ago. I think we talked about this product.
We might have.
Yeah, it's called Virtuoso System Design Platform. And it specifically targets people doing multi-die heterogeneous integration.
Yeah.
It does a very good job of tying together our Virtuoso platform. So that would include the entire tool suite within the Virtuoso platform, schematic capture layout and the simulation environment, tying that with this bi-directional bridge directly into our packaging technology and even extending into the board and again, our electrical modeling. So what it allows our customers to do is to drive the design intent from Virtuoso, do the implementation of their package and board, extract the layout parasitics of the package and board, and feed that back all the way back up into the front end of the IC platform where they would do their sign-off simulation. And one of the big benefits that our customers see in that flow is the ability to do LVS of the multi-die package. Historically, that's been a manual process, and this Virtuoso System Design Platform completely automates the process of doing the sign-off connectivity check on your multi-die package.
Okay, so let me get this right. You're adding packaging solutions to different new platforms.
Correct. Cadence has three primary implementation platforms. We have our Allegro technologies, which have historically been our PCB and advanced packaging platform. We have our Virtuoso suite of tools, which is our analog and full custom IC design tools. And then we have our Innovus implementation suite of tools for digital design. Because of kind of the line blurring and in many cases going away between what is a chip and what is a package,
yeah,
we've started to improve and add new functionality to the Innovus and Virtuoso platforms for advanced packaging. So those are traditional IC design platforms, and we're extending those to be able to support some of these new advanced packaging technologies. It's a work in progress that we'll announce the details of that for the Virtuoso platform later this year, but it is part of the Innovus platform today. Again, Innovus was used for the TSMC wafer-on-wafer flow as the implementation platform. So what Cadence is doing here is not only are we creating these vertically integrated cross-platform flows, but we're improving the point tools so that they have additional capability to be able to handle some of these modern day packages.
Cool. So this is more than just about implementation, right? It's
correct.
Worked its way all the way through the flow.
That's correct. It's about a complete flow, and that includes early planning with our OrbitIO tool, and it certainly includes all the back-end sign-off and verification tools. All of our suites of tools for our Qantas technology integrity have been improved to understand the types of structures that we're seeing in these advanced packages, like through silicon vias and micropumps. It ripples down from extraction through timing all the way through final DRC and sign off. So it's about a complete flow. It's bigger than just the implementation piece. Cadence looks at things holistically and makes sure that there's a complete flow from early planning all the way through tape out.
Okay, so John, I think I'm ready to wrap this thing up. Can you give me your main points?
Yeah, I think the main points are that Cadence has several different implementation platforms that have been extended and are available today to do the implementation of all of these advanced packages that we're seeing. The technology like CoWoS and WoW and fan-out wafer level packaging is now possible in the Cadence tools. And we, of course, think beyond just the implementation piece. That's one of the first things people think about is implementation. That's taken care of. But we also have extended all of our analysis capabilities and our sign-off tools. So it's a complete flow, as I said, from planning all the way through sign-off. All of the tools have been enhanced and extended so that they can support these advanced packaging technologies. And then finally, our partnerships with OSATs and with foundries and our customers to develop real designs. We couldn't just do it in a black box. You know,
right.
We collaborate quite a bit with the companies in this industry that are kind of driving the cutting edge. And that assures us and our customers that we have good technology.
Excellent. Well, I think that's all I have time for today. Thank you so much for joining me, John.
You're welcome. Thanks.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about system design enablement from Cadence Design Systems. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talk section of EE Journal. Can't miss it, right across the top. Or check out YouTube, keyword EE Journal.